Wining and dining at your favorite restaurant is a special experience, but do you know the work and craftsmanship behind the meal on your plate? Today, we are stepping back into the dining room to learn about the dance behind your dinner as we take time to turn the page on another newly released book. This morning on The Couch, we are joined by accomplished chef and author Michael Gibney, who has ties here to Western New York. You're out with a new book called Sous Chef 24 Hours on the Line. It's a great read if you have ever worked in a kitchen or if you've ever just been to a restaurant.
Thanks very much. Happy to be here.
Tell us a little bit about your experience. First of all, what is your connection here to Buffalo, and
how did you get your start? I grew up here in Buffalo. I was born and raised here, went to St. Joe's, and I got my first job. While I was at St. Joe's, a friend of mine on the baseball team, his father owned a restaurant, and they got me in washing dishes there. And I quickly realized that washing dishes wasn't the most glamorous of jobs to have, so that cooking was actually probably something I wanted to work on and work towards. And so I did what I had to do and made it to the line and got my start here, at Shannon Pub on Main Street in Buffalo.
Very nice.
Frying up wings.
Many of our viewers have probably experienced the food
there.
Yeah. And you went on to have a great cooking career. You're in the middle of a great cooking career in New York City.
Yeah, I moved to New York City when I was 18 to go to school. I went to art school, to a school called Pratt in Brooklyn. Studied there for 4 years and cooked throughout. And then afterwards, there weren't a whole lot of people, hunting me down on the streets with my painting career, with my painting degree. So I had to kind of resume cooking again. I started to draw connections between making a painting and making a plate of food. So I really began to take cooking serious. Got my first sous chef job. And I really started to think about how this is a career path maybe for me that kind of bridges the gap between the experience that I had frying wings here in Buffalo and the things that I was starting to learn in New York and what I learned when I was in art school about, you know, making something for people.
And I love that you are drawing the comparison between art and between being a cook, because if you pick up the book Sous Chef and read a couple of the chapters, you talk about cooking and working in a kitchen in a very poetic way. You really can tell that you respect the craft.
Well, for me, that's kind of what I wanted to focus on with the book was the craftsmanship that goes into it, the way that the people who do this thing and who have done this thing committed their lives to it, that it's not really about the melodrama. For them, it's about making a nice plate of food for people. It's about sharing a meal with somebody. For me, it's one of the greatest things, one of the greatest rewards in cooking is that if somebody comes in for their anniversary dinner, it's a special occasion for them. I get to participate in that by making a nice meal for them. You know, my effort directly translates into a nice experience for them.
It's like show business. Another great thing is that you talk about being the sous chef, which is the second in command to the executive chef.
Yes.
What is that relationship like in most kitchens?
It's usually a little tenuous because part of the thing is, as a sous chef, you're kind of in between being a cook and being a chef. You're no longer taking as many orders, you're giving some of them now, but you're not quite the executive chef. Your name's not on the menu. So for most sous chefs, the goal is to become that chef. So you have to. It's kind of a master and apprentice relationship that you develop with the person. You have to learn from them, but then also you have to kind of prepare yourself to take over their role.
It's a great book to read if you have, if you've ever stepped into a kitchen or not, if you just like to go eat at restaurants. You are going to be giving a speech tonight at Larkin Square.
Yes, today at Larkin Square, beautiful, at the filling station, beautiful, great place down there downtown in Buffalo, and we're going to be talking from 5 to 7 today, talking about books, talking about cooking.
All right, very nice. Thanks so much for joining us this morning on Winging at Buffalo Style. We appreciate
it.
Can't wait to finish your book, Michael. Thanks so much.